Good day, everyone. Hope you are adjusting to the new normal. I am here at this conference to present one of my research work, which is comparison of serum level of anti-malaria hormone in fertile and infertile women in Southwest Nigeria. I am Dr. Oke Elizabeth. These are those who participated in this work. And I'll be presenting using the following outline. By way of introduction, serum anti-malaria hormone, AMH, is solely produced in the human ovary by granulosa cells. AMH expression starts in primary follicles as soon as recruitment from the primordial follicle pool is initiated until the early antral stage, during which expression is more pronounced, and the expression ceases in follicle with a diameter between 8 and 10 mm. Based on this pattern, serum AMH was suggested to reflect the number of early growing follicles. Thus, AMH is exclusively of ovarian origin and is considered as both quantitative as well as qualitative biomarker for ovarian reserve. The level of AMH tend to decline with normal aging and become undetectable about 5 years preceding the final menstrual period. Recent studies have also shown that AMH is a better biomarker when compared with follicle stimulating hormone, EBB, and estradiol, to reflect the age-related decline of reproductive capacity and allows the early detection of an impaired ovarian reserve. Furthermore, AMH is also used as a predictive marker for the ovarian response to gonadotropin in assisted reproductive techniques. Many people have studied AMH serum level during the menstrual cycle. Some show you a late follicular peak in AMH levels, while other studies found no significant change during the menstrual cycle. Also, during pregnancy, serum AMH value in the first trimester are the same as the non-pregnant values and tend to decrease significantly as the pregnancy advances. Infertility is a disease of the reproductive system and is defined by the failure to achieve a clinical pregnancy after 12 months or more of regular unprotected sexual intercourse, with male and female factors contributing equally. The mean female age at first birth has increased steadily over the past few decades in both developed and developing countries, possibly due to increasing female literacy and increased career ambition to equal their male counterparts. Readily available contraceptive techniques has also enabled women to have more control over their reproductive lives, thus resulting in increased age at which they conceive. The prevalence of infertility in Nigeria is high, it's around 12.1%. And pregnancy rates following conventional treatment is poor. Also, with increasing age at conception worldwide and present availability of ART, a reliable marker is needed for proper monitoring of reduced ovarian reserve and response, of which AMH is now receiving a great attention worldwide. However, considering the peculiarity of the developing countries and the high cost of IVF, which a lot of you cannot avoid, normal levels of AMH can be used in the clinics as guidelines to predict fertility prospects. There are no readily available published values in the study environment for circulating AMH levels in fertile and infertile women that could serve as a guide in fertility clinics in evaluation of infertile patients, which was what stimulated these studies. Now to the objective of this study. The general objective was to compare serum level of anti-malaria hormone in the fertile and infertile women allowed to teaching hospitals, LTH in Ogbomoso and Oshogbo, Nigeria. Specific objectives were: one, to measure the level of AMH, LH, FSH, and estradiol in fertile and infertile women at the family planning and infant welfare clinic and fertility clinic of LTH. To establish any difference between AMH level in patients with primary and secondary infertility at these centers. Also to determine any relationship between level of AMH versus age of patient and infertility duration. To compare the level of AMH with the BMI of patients. And lastly, to determine any relationship between AMH and LH, FSH, estradiol in fertile and infertile women. Methodology. This case control study was done among 128 consecutive women. 64 were fertile. We are infertile participants who presented for infertility treatment, while another 64 were control participants who presented at family planning clinic for contraception and women who brought their children for immunization. 5 milliliters of venous blood was collected septically in consented eligible women on day 3 of the menstrual cycle into a well-labeled serum separator gel bottle. Sample separated and stored at minus 20 degrees Celsius till it is ready for analysis. Data obtained at the end of the study was analyzed using SPSS version 20 software. These are the following results obtained in this study. Table 1 shows social demographic data of the respondents, the age group, the religion, the marital status, education level, occupation, and number of years of marriage. Table 2 shows gynecological and reproductive history, of whether they have been pregnant before, number of miscarriages, and number of abortions. Table 3 shows the anthropometric measurements, which is the weight, height, and the body mass index, the BMI. Table 4 shows biochemical analysis of AMH, FSH, LH, and estradiol. Is study and control participants. Table 4 shows biochemical analysis in study participants with primary and secondary fertility in comparison with age. While Table 6 shows correlation between the level of AMH, age, and duration of infertility in study participants. And the last table, which is shows the correlation between AMH level and BMI in respondents. Now to discussion. Majority of the study participants belong to the age group 28 to 37 years, and more than half of them have university education. These findings are in keeping with the study that shows postponement of conception due to career pursuits and use of modern contraceptive method by couples planning to have children during a period when female fertility is already on a decline. Most of the study participants have 2 to 10 years of infertility, which is also in keeping with the high prevalence of infertility in Nigeria. Secondary infertility was found in majority of the participants in the study group, and this was comparable to the finding in other studies in sub-Saharan Africa. Adetoro et al. Observed secondary infertility in about two-thirds of women with infertility in a rural Nigerian community. In 2008, Sule et al. Also reported secondary infertility in 77.7% of infertile women in southwestern Nigeria. This study also showed that age range of those with secondary infertility are higher than those with primary infertility. The mean value of AIMH in the study participants is 2.66 plus or minus 4.23 nanogram per mil, which is significantly lower when compared with the control participants of 10.32 plus or minus 5.85 nanogram per mil. The difference in the mean value of AMH in the study could be due to early reduction in the number of premotor follicles left in the ovaries. The mean value of serum AMH in the infertile women was similar to the finding of Kaleselvi et al., where a value of 2.9 plus or minus 0.9 nanogram per mil was recorded. However, the mean serum AMH value of 3.8 plus or minus 1.6 nanogram per mil found in their study among fertile women is lower than the one obtained in the study. This may not be unconnected with the studied age range of 26 to 31 years and sample size of 60 used in the study. Moreover, the value of serum AMH findings in this study for fertile and infertile women are also in keeping with other studies. The mean value of LH among the infertile women in this study was higher when compared with the mean value in the fertile group. The difference could be due to early reduction in ovarian reserve in the infertile group. Studies have shown that elevated serum LH level in infertile women can lead to a significant reduction in the rate of fertilization and also increased risk of spontaneous miscarriages and failure of conception. This is supported by finding in these studies, which shows higher rate of miscarriages and failure of conception among the study participants when compared with the control. The mean value of FSH among the study participants was higher compared with the control, which is statistically significant and comparable to the result in Kaleselvi work, which represents a declining ovarian reserve and an increased day 3 FSH level, is considered as a late indicator of the marked decreased fertility potential. This further corroborates the findings by other researchers, showing there is decline in ovarian reserve among regular menstruating infertile women. Also, the mean value of estradiol among the study participants was also significantly higher compared with the control, a finding that is in keeping with other studies. It was also noted that the elevated value poorly predicts ovarian reserve and therefore should not be used alone. There was also difference between serum AMH level in study participants with primary and secondary infertility. Higher values of AMH in women with primary infertility may be due to younger age group when compared with those with secondary infertility who are older. This finding is similar to that obtained in another study where the mean serum AMH level was 4.23 plus minus 3.75 nanogram per mil and 2.2 plus or minus 2.47 nanogram per mil in primary and secondary fertility groups respectively. AMH negatively correlated with age among the infertile group and was compared to the correlation documented by Benye and Kaleselvi in their studies. This study also observed that serum AMH level correlated negatively with the relation of infertility. With a decline in serum AMH as the duration of infertility increases. This was, however, not statistically significant. The relationship between serum level of AMH and BMI also shows a negative correlation. This is in keeping with studies which shows obesity to be associated with decreased ovarian reserve and follicular dysfunction, which may eventually lead to infertility. Also, it was observed in this study that BMI of the study participants tend more towards obesity, a finding similar to Zeynep Özkandag study, which shows that anovulatory infertility was higher in overweight and obese patients, whose BMI was found to be greater than 26.9 kg per meter squared. In conclusion, the AMH level was significantly lower in the infertile women compared with the fertile, and it can be considered as a marker for assessing the ovarian reserve in women with normal menstrual cycles because it is cycle independent as compared to other hormones like FSH, LH, and estradiol. Our recommendations. There should be a balance between career and ambition, especially for women, to prevent couples attempting to have children during a period when female fertility is already on the decline. Anti-malarial hormone level can be routinely done via accessible in women of reproductive age group, both in married who present for infertility evaluation or unmarried so as to give room for early detection of reduced ovarian reserve with appropriate counseling. These are the references used in this study. Thank you for listening.